mistakes. I just make my case. Drop spike when I'm done. What more can I say? Not like to my tongue. I don't like the taste. I'm on in the moaning. I own my opponent. I'm always in the zone. Need a zone out of zone. And then we can get it poppin'. Pick the topic if you want to skip it. Shannon, skip it. Hoppin'. Took these sports and made them pop it. All right. Undisputed.
Everybody, and welcome to Undisputed Live from Los Angeles. I'm Jen Hale, here with Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharpe. Morning, morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, good morning. How you doing today, Skip? It ain't working.
Ticking.
That sticker ain't working.
Clock is ticking.
Kawhi,
what's happening? Where is he? What happened?
Don't worry about it.
This could be trouble.
For you.
Huh?
It could be trouble for you.
Somebody across from me predicted by 6 p.m. Monday night it would be over. Not over.
Kawhi Watch continues this morning, and that's really the only place to get started, right? We're all waiting to find out where the Claw will be playing next season. He's reportedly now met with the Clippers, Lakers, and Raptors. But Chris Broussard on this set yesterday said, nope, no decision has been made.
What?
Kawhi's camp apparently does not want any information about the decision-making process leaked. Mark Stein reports the Claw's inner circle is insisting on, quote, total silence during the negotiations. Shannon, what does it tell you that it's taken Kawhi so long
yes,
to make his
please,
decision?
Please tell us.
It's telling me is this is not a very easy decision, and he's going to take his time. And let's be all the way 100. I mean, 6 p.m. Sunday, they could start signing. So it's been about 72 hours.
It feels like 72 days.
No, but it's not.
Oh.
The difference is between Kawhi, Skip, and everybody else. Kawhi, we believed at the beginning of Kawhi. Kyrie, at the beginning of the season, we believe he was going to leave Boston. We believe the very same thing about Kevin Durant.
Mm-hmm.
I believe at the beginning of the season, Kawhi had made up his mind that he was going to leave. But there's a funny thing that happened on the way to the market. He happened to stumble into an NBA championship. Well, he didn't stumble into it. He earned it. Skip, you remember that commercial? Smith Barney, they make money the old-fashioned way. They earn it. Well, he earned a title. And he's earned the right to take as much time as he wants to in making this decision. Because
wait, what time out? He earned a title via injury to opponents?
Oh, my goodness.
Well, I mean, now he earned it?
No, he didn't.
Okay.
He beat Orlando. He beat Philly. He beat the number one seed, 60-22, Milwaukee. And then he took down a dynasty.
No, a virus beat Philly.
No, it wasn't nobody.
Double virus.
He was it.
Yeah.
Skip, he's earned the right to take as much time as he needs because this is a decision that's going to impact, let's just say he does a one-year deal. Who knows? Anywhere between 1 and 4 years, you want to make sure this is the place that I want to be. And this is going to give me the best opportunity to compete and win titles.
Uh-huh.
You see, Skip, this would have been a very easy decision had he not won the championship. Toronto, I mean, really, I really don't really like Toronto, but they made it tough on him. He won a title. And in the process of winning that title, he had a whole country behind him. He is emperor. He's king. Whatever you want to call it, that's what Kawhi Leonard is being revered as in that country.
Okay.
That made it very difficult. The Clippers. You know, he's like, well, I want to go to the Clippers. But guess what happened, Skip? Jimmy Butler, he going to Miami. KD's like, bro, I want to link up with you, but we need to be in New York. He's like, nope. So now, he's like, and then all of a sudden, the purple and gold, where it's at. They got the best player in the NBA going into his 17th season. They got a top five player in Anthony Davis, 26 years of age. And Kawhi had to sit back and say, wait a minute. Toronto, I know y'all love me. Y'all got much love for me, and I really appreciate everything you've done. You've been great to me. The Clippers, I know you got Steve Ballmer, who has deep, deep pockets. Jerry West, the logo. He's built many a team. Doc, I love Doc, but the Lakers. The Lego LeBron, King James, AD, the brow. How do I pass that up? So he's going to take...
So?
Hold on, wait a minute.
Wind it over.
Skip. Hold on, wait a second. It's pulling. It's pulling at him, pulling at his heart. Because Toronto, man, y'all was so good to me. You welcomed me in. The fans have been great. But the Lakers, Toronto... Lakers.
Oh, so
Toronto,
you're saying it's down to just Toronto? And
the Clippers
are dismissed. Out of sight, out of mind. Nobody's talking about the Clippers.
Clippers done.
Over. They're done.
Yeah.
Says Shannon Sharpe. Done. D-O-N-E.
Done. Done.
And we thought it was a done deal to the Lakers on Monday, correct?
So you know what? If I'm the Lakers, Skip, the Lakers should not be worried because, yeah, we love to have him and we believe we're in the catbird seat in order to get him. But anything that we get, we got the cake, Skip. And so now Kawhi just be adding frosting, sprinkles, Reese's Pieces, Snicker bar, whatever you want to add to the cake. Mm. That's all we do. We just add to the cake.
Okay.
So
your percentage now of number two, signing with the Lakers is up to what, 99?
I had it at 90%. And then Chris Broussard came, I said 94, 95. So now you know what, Skip? I feel very, very comfortable. I'm up to a whopping 94.3% that we're going to get Kawhi.
3, okay.
Yep.
So you've gone from 90 to 94.3,
yep.
Says Les Shannon Sharpe.
Yep.
Okay, got it. Got to listen to my watch again. Tick, 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 tick.
We got time.
Ticking time bomb. The ticking time bomb is not up in Toronto. It's the team that shares the building with the Lakers. Tick, 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 because they're at it as we speak. But they're at it in the shadows. They're doing so quietly because we hear nothing from the Clippers, right? We only hear tick, 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 because something is going on. Somehow the decision, the new decision, has become indecision because in free agent minutes and hours, this has gone into days because everybody else was ready to plunge by 6 Eastern on Sunday evening. Everybody else had done all their homework, all their research, all their deciding. It was ready to go boom, boom, boom. Dominoes are going to fall, except for one last domino. This guy,
yeah.
Number two, weirdest guy in the NBA, but he always has been. Never know what he's thinking. Maybe he's just playing it for all it's worth. Maybe I'm going to give you this. It's possible he decided long ago that he's going to wait all the way until the fireworks displays start tomorrow evening to set off his fireworks display. He's going to try to upstage America's fireworks displays with his own.
He going to do it.
Huh?
He go do it too.
And he's good, but it would. I would agree with you, especially if he dropped that Clippers bombshell.
What if he dropped that Laker grenade?
I don't know.
Ooh, Skip.
I'd go with bombshell over grenade, but that's just me. So to me, the longer the clock ticks, the better, not Toronto's chances, but the Clippers' chances. Because what do we know? We know there were rampant reports all through Monday, to your point of your prediction of 6 p.m. There were rampant reports that it was a done deal with the Lakers, right?
Yeah.
And yet, he still hadn't met with the Clippers as far as we knew at that point. And all we had was our man Kendrick Perkins, the Woj of ex-players, breaking the story that he was going to meet with the Clippers, said Kendrick Perkins. That's all I have to go on at this point, on Monday evening.
Right.
That would be the first session with some persuasive, powerful personalities. Doc Rivers, Jerry West, the logo, and Steve Ballmer.
What players are you going to have in that meeting?
I'm about to get to that.
Landry Shaman, huh?
No. There are two, actually, and I'm glad you brought one of them up because we've heard very little from the Clippers, but I did see one Patrick Beverley yesterday on ESPN. It was a very interesting interview because Patrick Beverley volunteered on ESPN. Actually, I did get my money, but I turned down more money from Sacramento. It really, you did. He turned down $10 million more. 3 years, $50 million from the Sacramento Kings to take 3 years, $40 million from the L.A. Clippers.
Right.
Why did you do that, Patrick Beverley? Well, I like what we're building here with the Clippers because we're a team on the verge. I have a better chance of winning Defensive Player of the Year with the Clippers because we're going to be a more successful team than Sacramento probably will be. And he also said because of Lou Williams, my man Lou. He said, I believe in Lou Williams. His character, his ability, and talk about powerful, persuasive personalities. Those two, Lou Williams and Patrick Beverley, are right up there with anything the Lakers can push.
Really?
Yes.
AD, this is high
regard and high respect.
AD and Bron.
You got it.
Okay.
High respect. These are gamers. These are tough-minded guys. This is a fourth quarter. He had the second most fourth quarter in overtime average points in the league this year.
Right now, Lou Williams, he'll leave the locker room right now and go for the Lakers.
That's how persuasive he is. He once was a Laker, and Magic Johnson dumped him.
And he'll come right back. He'll come right back right now.
Okay, so those two, you don't think they've quietly been in number two's ear? You don't think they have? Maybe as we speak.
And guess who else has been even quieter and been in his ear, Skip Bayless?
Who, Space Jam 2?
Yeah, you heard. all you know is that we followed our moves, is that we be on the set. We getting our work in on the set.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Yeah, you got one foot in Hollywood.
No,
by the way,